Lindsay is with us in Phoenix, Arizona. Hi, Lindsay. How are you?
Hello, kind sir. I'm great. How are you?
Better than I deserve. What's up in your world?
Well, I have a quick question for you. I'm a stay-at-home mom, and we are about, let's see, we're pretty new to your program. We've been trying to get it together for a couple years and are just now starting to get really, really serious. A little bit late, if you ask me, but we're trying. And we have about $23,000 in credit card debt on two of our cards, our Visa and our American Express. And then we have a few thousand on a couple other ancillary cards that we're going to pay off here with tax returns. And we've been, you know, doing it as quickly as possible. My question is, we've never been in this much debt before, and I'm honestly, I'm just freaking out about it. And I'm wondering if I should go back to work to help pay off the debt, or if I should just continue to stay at home with my kids, which I absolutely love to do. Mm-hmm. There is a little bit of, there's extra circumstances. So our 7-year-old is autistic, mm-hmm. and he has a lot of social and behavioral therapy. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people coming to the house to help him, and we go to a lot of appointments, and so it would be an adjustment and a change if I went back to work. Mm-hmm. But I just feel, to be honest, I just feel guilty. I just feel like I'm sitting here not contributing anything financially, and my husband is working like a dog. I'm so sorry.
Mm-hmm. What does he make?
Anyway.
What does he make?
About $65,000, I think, with overtime. He's been working a lot of overtime.
Yeah. And what's the last time you were employed in the marketplace?
Oh, gosh. Our 7-year-old is 7, so I gave my 9-month bonus when I got pregnant, so about 8 years.
Okay. And what were you making in those days?
$15 an hour. I was doing accounting. Mm-hmm. It was not anything I love to do, but just it paid the bills. We lived in Santa Barbara at the time. We were just being...
So is there any reason to believe you would make much more than that were you to go back in the marketplace today?
No. I mean, well, my family they're in real estate. So I could get my real estate license, and I have my mom and my uncle who are phenomenal at it. They make very good money. They would take me under their wing and help me learn the ropes. So I would probably go do real estate. But then I have to pay for real estate school, which would probably go on the credit cards. Mm-hmm. Or we just pay, you know, save up for it and then do it. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it costs money. I have to get my license, and that's probably what I would end up doing is real estate.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, real estate's a little different because it gives you a lot of flexibility. And the truth is most people look at houses when other people are off from work. They look at houses when they're off from work, so in the evenings and the weekends, which, by the way, is when your husband's available to help take care of your children.
Right.
So that would be a career that would actually be complementary and allow you to do, regardless of whether you earn money or not, if you wanted to do a career, that's the kind you would want to do, given the stresses on your household.
Right.
And so here's the thing. You guys have not been really working this system for very long, have you?
Oh, no. Yeah.
You were kind of playing with it around the edges, and he was like half in or not in, and you were trying to do it, and you were like sort of doing your version of my plan, which means you just weren't doing my plan. Is that right?
Right. That's okay. Pretty much the case. Yeah. We were just living in Santa Barbara, playing at the beach, having fun.
So now you're both on board and you're both ready to go?
Oh, we're really, now we're like extreme. We're, you know, we haven't eaten out in a really long time. We're, I think seeing our credit card debt.
How's the budget?
We did every dollar, mm-hmm. and that scared us to death. And it's funny because I heard someone on your program say they didn't really know how far in debt they were. And I thought to myself, how could you not know? And then we get on every dollar, and I seriously burst into tears and thought, how in God's name did we get here? Like, how did this even happen?
Here's what I would tell you today, okay?
Yeah.
You're finally ready, both of you, to do what it takes to win. You can get out of this debt with his income, and you're not doing anything wrong. There's nothing for you to feel guilty about. You're taking care of your kids, especially the fact you got a special needs one on your hands, which is double, triple time and intense. And were we to hire someone economically to do the job that you are doing, it would cost a lot.
Yeah, it would, probably.
And so I know it would. You hire somebody to take care of an autistic child? That costs a lot of money. I mean, it's a different kind of a care, right?
Yeah. Well, yeah, he's super high functioning,
but it's not just hiring a nanny. You know what I'm talking about. So no, my point is that you are very economically valuable sitting where you're sitting, and you have nothing to feel guilty about at all. I think the two of you need to work this plan hard for the first time ever, and I think you can do it. If you've not gone through Financial Peace University, now's the time for you to go through. Not because you're broke, but because you're ready to learn. You're actually ready to submit yourself to a plan. Hold on, I'll have Kelly give it to you.
Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, click the subscribe button to get the latest content and check out these other great clips from the show.